Welcome students to my class. Today I am introducing to you derivatives of the inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, for the first we have to take the formulas for the inverse trigonometric functions. You know about the trigonometric functions. What are the trigonometric functions? They are sine, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosec. These are the trigonometric functions. And what are the inverse trigonometric functions? Like this, that is sine inverse of x. This is the inverse trigonometric function. You know about it. Okay. Then, what is the derivative of this? I am going to introduce this. Okay. This is the function. Let us consider the functions of the trigonometric functions as y and that is equal to f of x. That is the function of x, means the trigonometric functions are in the variable x. Therefore, I have taken this as y is equal to f of x. And what are the derivatives of that functions and what are the conditions of that inverse trigonometric functions? Therefore, we have to take on that is y is equal to f of x and derivative of it is denoted by f dash of x or dy by dx also. Let us take the first trigonometric function, that is sine x, and inverse of that is sine inverse of x. Okay, this is sine inverse of x and the derivative of that it is, okay, that is sine inverse of x, derivative of that is equal to 1 upon, what is the derivative of sine x? Derivative of sine x is equal to cos x. And what is the derivative of this sine inverse of x is equal to 1 upon under root of 1 minus x square. Here, one of the condition is that is what is the value of x is here, where the value of x is less than 1 because it is 1 minus x square. Therefore, the condition for that is equal to the condition for that is mod of x is less than 1 always. Then only the derivative of the inverse trigonometric function, that is sine inverse of x, is equal to 1 upon under root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Then next is cos inverse of x. Next trigonometric function is cos inverse of x and the derivative of this is whenever there is a cos, means c becomes in the trigonometric function, then only we take the negative sign for the derivatives of that trigonometric functions. Like this, in this inverse trigonometric function, we have to take the negative sign for the derivative of this cos inverse of x because here is c. Therefore, minus 1 divided by 1 minus x square. For the derivative of this also, the condition is mod of x is less than 1 because here 1 minus x square. Okay. Next is third function is tan inverse of x. And derivative of this tan inverse of x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Okay. And tan inverse of x, that is the third trigonometric function. That given that inverse trigonometric function and then derivative of this is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Next is fourth function. Tan inverse of x, then we have to take then cot inverse of x. We have to take the function that is cot inverse of x, that is f of x. And what is the derivative is f dash of x. Then derivative of this is minus 1 upon 1 plus x square. That is whenever becomes c in the trigonometric function, then we have to take the derivative, that is a negative sign, 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus x square. Remember this, students, okay? Always remember this. Don't forget this and don't learn by learn. It is only the by think about the tricks of this, how to understand and how to learn about the formulas here. What are the tricks about the trigonometric function? It is called inverse of x is equal to minus 1 upon 1 plus x square. Next is sec inverse of x. This is the sin inverse of x is equal to 1 upon under root of 1 minus x square and cos inverse of minus 1 by 1 minus x square. And what by about the sec inverse? That is equal to 1 upon x into under root of, that is equal to x square minus 1. Then x is greater than 1. X square minus 1. And the condition is x is greater than 1. Then only we get the derivative of the sec inverse of x is equal to 1 upon x into under root of x square minus 1. And next trigonometric function is cosec inverse of x. This cosec inverse of x, then the derivative of this is equal to, whenever there is c, what is the trick for the trigonometric derivatives of the trigonometric function? That is how to remember this formulas here. Whenever there is c in the trigonometric function, then only we get the negative sign for the formula of the derivative, that is minus 1 divided by x into under root of this x square minus 1, and here only, that is x is greater than 1. These are the standard inverse trigonometric functions, and these are the derivatives for that standard inverse trigonometric functions. Let us see here and repeat it, students, and how to remember this. And there are tricks for remembering, and not only by only learning the formula. Whenever we learn the formulas, you thought about it and use the tricks for remembering these formulas for the derivatives of the inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, students, remember this and use the tricks for this inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, let us take another trigonometric functions, and what are the formulas for the another inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, let us see for the six formulas, and we are going to for the next trigonometric functions, and what are the formulas for the trigonometric functions. Let us now go to forward important formulae for the inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, these are the derivatives, but what are the important formulae for the inverse trigonometric functions? Let us see here and how to remember it. And we are using these formulas, important formulas, for solving the examples of the derivatives. Some important formulas. For inverse trigonometric function, I have to use the ITF for this inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, let us now start for the functions. First function is sine inverse of sine of theta. Here theta may be used, or here may be that variable is used for this formula. Sine inverse of sine of theta. Let us see here. These two are sine functions. Then only we can write it as theta. For this formula, we write it as theta. Let us see here. Sine inverse of sine of theta. Also, cos of theta is equal to also theta. Here, inside and outside functions are same. This is the inverse function, and this is the only function, that is trigonometric function. Then third formula is, that is tan inverse of tan of tan inverse of tan of theta, that is equal to also theta. This is tan inverse of tan of theta is equal to theta. Students, whenever their inside and outside functions are same, then only we get this. Here we can use by, that is x, k theta by x. Let us see the next function, that is equal to cot inverse of cot of theta, then it again gets theta. Next, fifth is the sec inverse of sec of theta, that is equal to also theta. Next, sixth is cosec inverse of cosec theta, that is equal to also theta. These are the some basic and some important formulae for the cos inverse of that, cos sin inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, cot inverse, sec inverse and cosec inverse of the trigonometric functions, and we get the variable or angle of the trigonometric functions. Okay, let us see here another some important formulas for. Then we see what is about the, that is sin inverse of sin theta. But whenever we get sin inverse of cos, then only what can we do? Let us see here. Sin inverse of, suppose it becomes cos of theta, then it can be written as in the format of sin. This cos can be written in the terms of sin, then it gets sin inverse of sin of, let us change the theta, that is theta is equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Then only we get this cos by sin. Whenever we changes this pi by 2 minus theta, how to change cos to sin? Let us see here, that is sin of pi by 2 minus theta becomes cos theta. Then the formula is become sin inverse of sin means theta, that is theta is pi by 2 minus theta. Then only by using this type we write all these 6 formulas for this, that is equal to cos inverse of sin theta. That also it can be written as sin inverse of this, cos inverse of sin of theta. It can be written as sin, it can be written as in terms of cos. This is outer side is cos inverse, therefore we can change the inside, that is sin theta is changed by cos. By using the formula that are the basic formulas for you, that is cos of pi by 2 minus theta, and it gets pi by 2 minus theta. Then cos inverse of sin theta, then again next formula, that is tan inverse of this cot of theta, it can be also changes. What can be change? Cot inverse of tan theta, that is equal to also this, and tan inverse of cot theta, it can be also changes the inside cot by tan. Then only we get the formula for this. Then how to change this tan inverse of cot? It can be changes by tan of pi by 2 minus theta, and that is equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Similarly, we can write all the trigonometric functions in this same way and change the inside function as to the same outside function. Then only we get the formula for the this inverse functions theorem. Okay, that tan inverse of cot theta, we get pi by 2 minus theta. Then what is about cot inverse of tan of theta? In this same way, we can change this cot inverse to cot. This tan can be changed by the cot by using the basic formulas of the allied angles, that is cot inverse of tan of theta can be changes to the cot theta, that becomes cot of pi by 2 minus theta, and it is equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Okay, this is cot inverse of tan of theta. Okay, let us take this I have to rough this and take next further formulas for the inverse trigonometric function. Cot inverse of tan theta. Let us take here sec inverse. Sec inverse of cosec theta. It can be also cosec theta can be changes to. Changes to sec theta. Then sec inverse of, it can be written as sec of pi by 2 minus theta, and it is equal to becomes pi by 2 minus theta. When only these two are equal, that is inside function and outside function, then only we get pi by 2 minus theta, that is original theta. Okay, some basic allied angles are there. Okay, let us see. Next is cosec theta, that is cosec inverse of sec of theta. It can be written as cosec inverse of cosec of, changing the sec theta into cosec theta, that is cosec of pi by 2 minus theta. These are the very important formulas for the inverse trigonometric function. This cosec inverse of cosec of pi by 2 minus theta, it gets equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Write down it and let us see here, students. One of another 10 formulas are here remaining, that is sine inverse of x. It can be written as cosec inverse of 1 upon x. Remember this, sine is converted to cosec and this x is converted to 1 upon x. That is sine inverse of x is equal to, it can be written as cosec inverse of 1 upon x also. Okay. It can be also written in this term also. This cosec, let us take this cosec inverse of x, and that can be also written as sine inverse of 1 upon x. Understand about this? What is this? Sine inverse of x is converted to cosec, and this cosec is converted to sine inverse. These are the very important formulas for the inverse trigonometric function. Let us take another, that is cos inverse of x. It can be written how? This is written as sec inverse of 1 upon x, and this sec inverse of x can be written as this cos inverse of 1 upon x. Next, students, that is go to the next inverse trigonometric function, that is sec inverse of x is equal to, what is this, changes to sec inverse to cos, and this cos inverse to, that is cos inverse to sec inverse, and sec inverse to cos inverse. Let us take here sec inverse. Okay, that is tan inverse. Next inverse trigonometric function is tan inverse of x. First take, we have to take sin inverse, next to cos inverse, and next to tan inverse of x, and changes to alternatively, that is equal to, what is changes in this tan inverse, that is equal to cot inverse of this 1 upon x. And what about this cot inverse of x? Cot inverse of x, it can be changes to tan inverse of 1 upon x. Okay, these are the some formulas for this examples of the we have to use these formulas for solving the examples. Let us check here, sin inverse x is changes to cosec inverse, cosec inverse is changes to sin inverse, and this cos inverse changes to sec inverse, tan inverse changes to cot inverse, and cot to this tan inverse of 1 upon x. Let us see here, we have already studied in the 10th from the 10th standard that the identities. What are the identities? Sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. We are using the inverse trigonometry functions for this formula. That is sin inverse of x plus cos inverse of x. That gets is equal to, what is the value of this? That is equal to 1. You have already used the identities, that is sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. We have using the inverse trigonometric functions, and it is equal to pi by 2. Let us see how to get tan inverse of x plus cot inverse of x, it is also written as pi by 2. Remember this formulas, students. Otherwise, you cannot solve the examples. Let us see sine inverse plus cos inverse, tan inverse plus cot inverse, and remaining is sec inverse of x plus cosec inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Also, these are the same values for this left side, that is sine inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, cot inverse, sec inverse, cosec inverse of x, and that are equal to pi by 2. We are using these are the most important formulae for solving the examples. Let us take one of the most important formula, that is tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y. There are two variables, that is tan inverse of x and tan inverse of y, that is equal to tan inverse of. We are adding these two inverse function. First is tan inverse of x and second one is tan inverse of y, and using this this is the formula for this addition of these two inverse function with the different variables, that is tan inverse of this x plus y divided by 1 minus x into y. For the plus sign we have to use here plus sign, and in the denominator we have to use that is minus sign, and for minus sign, that is tan inverse of x minus tan inverse of y. What is the formula for this? That is equal to tan inverse of x minus y divided by, it becomes 1 plus x into y. Okay. Whenever there is x into y is less than 1, then only we can use this formula for the solving the formulas. Remember all these formulas of the inverse trigonometric function, students, and do not only learn about it, use the tricks and remember it, not to repeat it and learn it only. Okay, let us see what are the formulas for the inverse trigonometric functions, and I am going to further to the exercise 1.2. okay, let us see all the formulas for the inverse trigonometric functions and how, what are the derivatives of the inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, remember it and use the trick for the remembering these formulas. Okay, let us take care. Thank you, students.